Hello, my name is Debbie Reynolds. They call me the Data Diva. Today I want to talk about data privacy, smart cities, and fusion technologies. Fusion technologies are technologies that are used or developed to connect different types of data sets and data sources to one another. Fusion has been used mostly in things like the military, government, stuff with surveillance, law enforcement, things like that. But as cities get more technologically capable and as more data is out there to be captured, more of those types of technologies are going to be able to be used within cities. You think about things like traffic light cameras, listening devices for phones to see where people are in terms of their location. Things like license plate scanners, any information like CCTVs, images on buildings or smart doorbells. Because all of those things have data capabilities, cities are looking to find ways to be able to connect that information together, as opposed to having them be different sources that can't really either communicate with one another or be able to gather insights. As things like 5G come on board, and as, again, more types of devices are communicating and gathering data, I think cities are going to continue or will sort of ramp up their capabilities to be able to plug this information in. So things like, reports from individuals about incidents, looking at, for example, being able to maybe rewind or replay incidents that happen in certain areas in terms of investigations, or just to try to do things to make sure that the public good is being served and the communities are safe. Obviously, this brings on a lot of issues or a lot of concerns about privacy of individuals in terms of how data is retained and kept, how surveillance, even if it's passive, how is that information being used in the future? How are people, let's say, for instance, someone has some type of criminal activity in the past, and that's in the past, are those people still surveilled in the same way? So as these technologies, again, continue to become more mature, there will be a need for those that information to be sort of knitted together in some way to be able to make sure that communities and cities can, protect their citizenry and also be able to make sure that they're using technologies in the wisest way possible. So I'm interested to see how a lot of these initiatives go. I've seen quite a few of these initiatives go forward in the city of Chicago probably for the last 20 years. But I think as the technology grows and gets more in the hands of consumers in terms of things like smart devices and being able to connect all that information, from drone imagery and things like that, I think it's going to become very, very interesting as we live and thrive in cities. That's it. Thank you.